If you take bar bodies, so bar bodies, so these bar bodies were first identified by the Murray L. Barr scientist, sir. Who observed for the first time bar bodies? Murray L. Barr scientist. Sir, what are bar bodies? Let us see. Generally, in the females, how many X chromosomes are present in the human beings? 2X chromosomes are present. If the genes which are responsible for the femaleness, if their presence is taking place on the X chromosome, and when the 2X chromosomes are there, it increases dosage of the characters. Isn't it? If female determining genes are there and 1X chromosome, they are enough to express the female character. Okay now. So when another X chromosome is also possessing same type of genes, then what happened? The character dose will be increased. Character dose will be increased. So this is called as dosage. So in order to prevent the dosage, one of the 2X chromosomes undergoes inactivation or undergoes heterochromatinization. Then it is called as dosage compensation, sir. Means if it is expresses its character, it also expresses characters. Then what happens? Dose will be increased. Character dose will be increased. So in order to stop this dose, one of the 2X chromosomes becomes inactivated. By which process, sir? Heterochromatinization. Okay, so this is called as dosage compensation. How the dosage compensation is achieved? It is achieved by the inactivation of one of the 2X chromosomes in the females. Let us see what is the history of Barr bodies discovery. Okay, na? Sir, here, if you take the Barr bodies were first observed by, already I said, who is that fellow? Barr and Bertram. Barr and Bertram. Okay. Sir, here Barr and Bertram observed in the nerve cells of female cat. So where they observed the Barr bodies? Actually, Barr and Bertram, when they observed the nerve cells of female cat, which are in interphase nerve cells of cat, if you say in the male, there is a special kind of structure. And that same structure is not present in the male. That is they observed. So later, the same structure, heterochromatinized structure, they observed in the cheek cells or mucosa, cells of mucosa, as well as fibroblast cells of females. So here, when they observed the mucosa, comma, fibroblast cells of the females, there is again a special kind of structure which is not present in the males. So this mucosa fibroblast of the females also denoted that there is a special kind of structure which is not present in the males. Later, if you see the WBC of the females, there is a special kind of structure which is looking like drumstick. So this is a nuclear structure. And this drumstick model of nuclear structure only seen in the individuals what? Female. But absent in the males. So here, finally, when these kind of investigations were seen by the scientists, they decided that in the males there is a special kind of absence. In the males there is a special kind of structure is absent, whereas in the females that special kind of structure is present, isn't it? So they started that, what is this structure? Only it is seen in females and it is not seen in the male's nucleus of any cell. Okay, now first they observed what? Nerve cells of female cat. There is a special kind of nuclear structure. And if you take male cat nerve cells, that structure is not present. And if you take mucosa and fibroblast cells of women, so that nucleus has a special kind of structure. But in the males, that is absent. WBC and WBC, if you see, white blood cells of the women, there is a drumstick model nuclear structure that is absent in the males, only present in the females. So finally, so this is nothing but heterochromatinized X chromosome. So now, then it is called as, it is Barr body. See, Barr body is nothing but heterochromatinized, inactive, transcriptionally inactive X chromosome.